haven't been able to enjoy the Queen City Road Race for a couple of years, but now it's back and bigger than ever, and we're really excited about that. I'm Micah Terrell with WAPX-FM 91.9 Public Affairs and APSU-TV, and joining me today with more about the big Queen City Road Race and Health Expo is Maggie Houts from Clarksville Parks and Rec. Maggie, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So tell us about the big races now. So we're back, you know, and it's a little, hopefully a little safer for everybody, obviously with COVID being a concern, but lots of big races. Tell us about all of those.
Yeah, so Queen City Road Race has been going on for over 40 years, and it is pretty much that premier running event for Clarksville. So I know everyone's always looking forward to it. And creating that running experience is a priority for us. So we're really lucky to have this every year, and it gives that runners that accomplishment feeling to run in a place that we care about. So every year we try to elevate the experience for our runners and participants.
Right. So you have a lot of things. You have something for everybody, really. Mm-hmm. You have the 10K, the 5K, and then like a 1 mile for maybe somebody who's maybe not as experienced a runner. Tell us a little bit about those two.
Yeah. So for our 1 mile, it's more of a fun run. Walkers or runners are, of course, welcome. And this is a really cool experience to just take a walk in the park around of our pond. And then for 5K runners, a little bit of more difficulty, but still a really nice jog along the parks, and you get to experience all the different corners of Liberty Park. And then the 10K run is a really fun run. It's a very flat course, and it's for those who want to kind of give themselves a little bit of a challenge. So they get to run outside of Liberty Park along Riverside Drive, get to do the beautiful view of Cumberland River, and then through McGregor Park, and then back to Liberty Park. So it kind of Queen City Road Race gives that different level of opportunity for all of our runners.
Right, and like you said, though, still nice scenery, no matter which one you mm-hmm. pick, so it's really cool. And yeah, because Liberty Park's gorgeous, so especially
Absolutely.
This time of year. And now let people know, obviously, this is in May, so it's going to be a little warmer and lots more, you know, we'll have trees and lots more fun, you know, now that things are just starting to bloom and everything. So yeah, so cool. Now tell us about the expo, too. So that's a really cool part of that. The expo has a lot of, it's free, of course, and folks can come and check that out. What can people expect to see when they go there?
Yeah, so the expo is a new thing that we're adding this year. We wanted to expand on not just runners but also the entire Clarksville community. So it's a two-day expo, which pretty much will bring all together businesses who want to show off their products and service, all in health, fitness, and nutrition related. So this health and fitness expo is also going to be a packet pickup for our runners. So it is going to be on Friday, May 6th from 4 to 8 p.m. at the Wilmar Rudolph Event Center. And then Saturday, it's going to happen after the race from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Right. So the expo will just be a great way to get the kids together, the family, everyone together, all in one roof, celebrating and educating on health and fitness.
Yeah, and that was going to be my question. So mm-hmm. for the kids, because I was hoping it was like, you know, you bring the kids along and have fun, any activities for them too, probably?
Yeah, so we are going to actually showcase Clarksville and Parks and Rec divisions. So each of our divisions, athletics, aquatics, Fort Defiance, special events, we all are going to be having a booth at the expo, so all the kids can enjoy a couple of activities that each of our booths are going to provide. And then we're also going to have a fitness zone, and that is going to happen in the amphitheater up the Wilmar Rudolph Event Center, and it's going to showcase a couple of other gyms that we have lined up for this, so for the whole entire public can really exercise outdoors and be all together.
And bring your crazy toddler child of mine.
Yes.
get them worn out so they can go to sleep.
Right.
So great. Yeah. Now, what about the, obviously we talked about the expo and it's free and everything. Any other special fun stuff that's happening, you know, maybe around the race themselves or anything like that, that people need to know about too, that might be associated with it?
So one of the cool things that we have for this year as part of the race is we are working on initiatives of how we can continue to stay green. So for the first time ever, we're doing a cup-free race event.
Cool.
So we're eliminating all the water paper cups, and every runner will be receiving a Hydra pack, hydration, something like that sort that people will be able to hold and run and hydrate throughout the course. We have a DJ that's coming in, and he will be providing a bunch of entertainment for all of our spectators and also for our runners. We have a bunch of food trucks coming out, all health-based, and also juice makers, coffee vendors. Like I said, this is just, again, a whole just think of a world full of health and fitness.
That's amazing. So, that's great. So it's, in case you're just tuning in here to Austin P, our APSU TV station, or 91.9 FM, I'm Micah Terrell, and I'm talking with Maggie Houts from the Clarksville Parks and Rec, and we're talking about the really cool Queen City Road Race and obviously the Health Expo. Health Expo's got a lot of cool stuff. Like you're saying, it's like, it sounds like a monster affair with lots of food trucks and entertainment with the DJ and free stuff for the kids and lots of fun things. So a lot to check out for sure. Mm-hmm. Any idea yet how many folks have signed up for the road race yet?
So we are around 300 people. Our goal is to hit 1,000 runners.
Yeah.
So we're going to close registration once we hit that 1,000 participants. But we have a feeling, especially after COVID, that everyone wants to just get out there, get into the parks, and why not have some fun and add a little running to it.
Right. And what are some of the cool things that you sign up for the races? Obviously, you get your tags and everything that you'll wear. What is there, like, medals and some other cool stuff that the runners get too?
Yeah, so for the 10K and 5K, the race is going to be timed, so it'll be a great way just for people to see their pace. And then also, every running participant will receive a shirt. They'll receive a finisher medal, and then also additional other fun little items that we're including in the race packet pickup. So it's going to be a surprise. We don't want to share all of the details right now, but definitely we'll be coming home with some good goodies.
I was going to say, it sounds like a nice swag bag for sure.
Definitely.
That's cool. Yes. Now, how many, because I know in past times, I know it's been a while, because like you mentioned, the race has been around for 40 years, which is an amazing thing unto its own. How many people from maybe other countries or other states have signed up yet? I didn't know if you had any ideas yet on how many folks have been interested from around, you know, not just in Clarksville.
Oh, boy. Okay, so I really don't know.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay. So, I'm just curious because I know the proximity to Nashville and the races there always seem to generate a lot of interest, you know, from elsewhere and everything. Obviously, we want to have a lot of visitors.
Our goal
come.
Is to always expand. We want to reach beyond Clark. Reaching to Clarksville, obviously, is our main priority, but we're hoping to expand even more beyond Clarksville. I mean, kind of the reason why we're trying to make this more of a competitive race, at least for the 10K, because we want the 10K to be that next step for our competitive runners to move on and do the half marathon wherever they want to do, or even the marathon. So the 10K and 5K are USA certified. So this will also be another opportunity, not only just for those who want to get out there and experience health and fitness, but also those who want to be competitive.
Right, and obviously individuals or teams are welcome, right?
Mm-hmm. Cool. Yes,
very
absolutely.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Now, how do these kinds of events, which obviously are really important, you mentioned the whole recycling aspect, which is great, but how do you think events like these really help people in Clarksville get more in tune with their health, which is really important in Tennessee? We don't really have the healthiest over on average people. How do you think this kind of helps us get more in tune with being healthful?
Yeah, so with the Queen City Road Race, I mean, in events in general for Clarksville Parks and Recreation, our goal really is to, throughout our events, to educate Clarksville that even just one small thing can really make a big difference. So especially with even this 1 mile walk run, that just a simple walk around the park, that's being healthy. It doesn't have to be a dramatic change, it's just step by step. So really with our programs and events, we always try to want to make it our health and fitness as a fun thing, not as a chore.
Right, exactly. So, some people are just like, ugh, you know, I don't want to do that. Mm-hmm. Now, what about that 1 mile walk? Is it open to any age group, or is it just for adults? I didn't know, you know, what age requirements you might have for those.
Yeah, so it is open to everyone. For 13-year-olds and younger, it's going to be $5, and then for 14 and up, it's $10. So, but it's open to every single person that just wants to go out and have a walk in the park.
Good, nice. Mm-hmm. Now, also wanted to bring up too, because again, obviously, folks with disabilities might want to take part too. Is there anything special that they need to do, or can they just sign up and join in and, you know, wheel along or do whatever they'd like to do too?
That's exactly what you said.
Awesome.
Everyone, we accept everyone, and it's open. The park is open to any single person.
Nice. So. Very cool.
Mm-hmm. We accommodate to everyone.
Cool. So if people wanted to sign up, what should they do to register, and how was there, what deadline is there they need to look out for?
So in order to receive a t-shirt, the registration deadline is April 22nd, and all you have to do is go to clarksvilleparksrec.com.
Nice.
Find out more information, and you can register through there.
Very cool. Very cool. So, yeah. So, again, if you're just tuning in to us here at APSU TV and 91.9 Public Affairs, I'm Micah Terrell, and this is Maggie Houts with Clarksville Parks and Rec. So, Maggie, just to recap again, a huge deal. Again, Queen City Road Race, as you mentioned, is one of the premier races and has been kind of on hold like a lot of things have been, but it's back and it's bigger than ever. And you mentioned a huge campaign to let people know about that it's here again. Obviously, you're talking with us. You've talked to lots of people. What's the reception been so far? Have people just like, yay, that's great? I mean, what you're kind of getting from people?
People are so excited. We're just really excited in general just to have events in person again. There's always a difference between virtual and in person, but with this Queen City Road Race being in person and all the new things that we're implementing, it really just shows that we are a community and we want to bring people together, and this is just a great opportunity also to celebrate fitness.
It is. And again, like we were talking about, fitness is supposed to be fun, and this sounds like a really fun thing to do. So yeah. So you mentioned a lot of food trucks at the free expo, which is, and again, if you could remind folks of the dates for the expo too, that's part of the road race.
Yeah. So the expo is 2 days on Friday, May 6th, from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. at the Wilma Rudolph Event Center, and then also the second day is on Saturday, May 7th, from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Wilma Rudolph Event Center.
2 days of fun.
Yeah. So it'll be a race in the morning and then the health fitness expo in the afternoon.
Very cool. And again, if you don't mind mentioning the website one more time, where people can go for more info.
ClarksvilleParksRec.com.
Great. Now, we've talked about a lot. What else did you want to say that I didn't ask you about that folks would probably want to know who are listening or watching?
Everything was said.
And how much fun has it been for you helping get the word out? And again, I know you're from Wisconsin, which again is a different world altogether. And then here in Tennessee, our springtime is crazy and different. What's it been like?
It's a blast. Yeah. I love health and fitness. So to be able to mix in event planning and health and fitness and to bring people together, that is the perfect picture.
Awesome. And again, lots of great freebies for all the runners who sign up. They get again, you mentioned for staying hydrated, we don't have the paper cups anymore. Tell us about that again one more time.
Yeah, so we are, with our environmental initiative, we are eliminating all the paper running cups, and everyone is going to be receiving a hydration item to hydrate throughout the race. So it's just another fun little key aspect as a reminder of not only are we being healthy and getting involved in that, it's also keeping aware of the environment.
Right. And then, of course, after they're done with the race, lots of goodies at the food trucks, lots of great. And you mentioned quite a few food trucks. Any idea how many are going to be there just yet?
Like 5 to 10. We're still working on it, but it's going to be a good lineup for sure. And all health-based is what the goal is.
Right. So good. Good stuff. Great, Maggie. And again, wanted to ask too, if folks wanted to sign up, they have the certain deadlines they have to meet to get the t-shirt, right? So what was that?
So that would be April 22nd will be the last date for you to register in order to get guaranteed a t-shirt. However, we are allowing registration past that date, but April 22nd is that key one if you want your shirt.
Right, and again, you mentioned all ages who want to take part in the 1 mile. That's a great one for anybody,
for anyone.
Yeah, great. And then, obviously, we wanted to make sure we told folks, again, it's a 10K, a 5K, and then a 1 mile. So there's something for everybody, all different skill levels. Right.
Yep. Then also, did forget to mention one thing. Another thing we're doing this year is called the combo race. Mm-hmm. So it's a 10K and 5K run. So for those competitors who are wanting to get more challenge, that it would be a perfect way to combine both of those together.
Right, and it's quite quite the course that you guys, I mean, Liberty Park is a big part of it for the 10K, obviously, but then you go down Riverside Drive, and there's a lot to obviously, that's going to be quite a run.
Yes,
for sure.
At least it's flat, though, that's a bonus.
Exactly, good. Awesome. Yeah. Well, Maggie, thanks so much for stopping by. I appreciate
it. We're so excited.
And thanks so much for tuning in. I'm Micah Terrell with 91.9 Public Affairs and APSU TV.